how many steps should be between receiving a notification and acting on it. When notification actions were introduced in Jelly Bean, this number dropped to 1. Just tap an action right there. Direct reply seeks to make it just as easy to receive text input from the user right in line in the notification. This involves superpowering one or more of the actions you add to your notification with a remote input. This is how the system knows to ask for input from the user and then forward it on to your app. This is actually the exact same API used to add voice input to your notifications on Android Wear, but is now available on phones and tablets. So we'll have a notification with an action with a remote input. The remote input is what stores information like the hint text, the text that appears before the user types anything in, and the key, a unique string used to later retrieve what the user typed in. The action here is pretty standard. Of course, we'll want to use addRemoteInput to add our remote input object. There's also a setAllowGeneratedReplies method if you want to enable Smart Reply on Android Wear 2.0 watches. Well, we are trying to make things easy for users, right? Totally worth enabling. There is one other thing we need to be aware of, the pending intent we're passing in here. Turns out what kind of pending intent you pass in matters a lot. For direct reply, the system is doing the UI portion for us. So using a service or broadcast receiver is exactly what we need. This also allows it to work even when the device is locked. Awesome. But on devices that don't support direct reply, you need to start your own UI, namely an activity. Avoid trying to start an activity from a service or broadcast receiver pending intent. The notification shade won't automatically dismiss, and users will need to manually unlock a locked device, leaving users unsure if anything actually happened. So we'll want to use an activity on Marshmallow and lower devices, and a service or broadcast receiver for our new direct reply supported devices. Now onto the notification itself. The best part, direct reply doesn't care about your notification at all. As long as you add the action, you're good to go. Of course, we did build a fancy messaging style. So if you're a messaging app, these two go perfectly together. Magical. So let's say we're ready to receive our reply and chosen a broadcast receiver. Appropriate if we're okay with only using the main thread. We can then use code such as this to extract the text from the intent passed in. You'll note we use remote input get results from intent to get a bundle, and then use that key we passed into the remote input here to retrieve the text. Of course, if you stop here, you'll notice your remote input just keeps on spinning forever. So there's one last step, updating your notification. Updating the notification is how you tell the user the text has been saved or the message has been sent. For example, if you're using messaging style, you just append your message to the style and rebuild your notifications. For other styles, you can and should use set remote input history, which will append the message or messages to the bottom of the notification. Now, keep in mind, I said update, not cancel. You want to tell the user it succeeded rather than leaving them hanging. So add a remote input to your notifications actions to enable direct reply. Check out all the links in the description for more information on how it all works as you continue to build better apps.